Hi guys, welcome to my quick review of the Korg Minilog synthesizer. This is not a classic review as maybe one of Bo Beats or Pianoschenk or something. This shall be more a review or more a help for you to decide whether you shall buy this synthesizer or not. And I will give you a few pros and cons for it and maybe it help you to decide. If you want to pick up one or not. I had one of these 1 year ago, then I tried it. I didn't like the sound because I was thinking it's a little bit too metallic in sound. So here, maybe you can hear it. And this is because of the VCOs, I think. This is a voltage controlled synthesizer, not a digital controlled analog oscillators. And this makes this specific sound. It's a little bit dirtier than a digital controlled analog synthesizer. But if you like this dirt, so if you look for this, this synthesizer is great. And so now, why should you maybe buy this synthesizer these days? If you want to go in subtractive synthesis, in analog synthesis and start with it, there are other synthesizers around. Everybody would say maybe, I'll start with a Juno 106 or something. But I have to say, hey, we have now great analog synthesizers these days produced. And this is one of them, and it's really a good price. The first one I buy it for the normal price. Then second time I sold this, and then second time I found one for 350 francs. This is $350, around that. And you can find them around that price, $400 maybe, and this is a big deal. So why this synthesizer is cool for beginning with synthesis? Because it's really easy. So it has all these knobs, so you can do the most things on these knobs, and it's great for learning. And then you see, especially this oscilloscope here, a lot of people would say this is this is only a gimmick for playing around, nothing helpful. But I would say this is a great feature when you learn synthesis, because when you see now, when I press something, you can see the waveform of changes. Here's a sawtooth, triangle, square wave. You can modulate the sound here, but you cannot do a lot of things wrong. So if you make a sound, you can choose a waveform. Let's take a triangle, then you have two oscillators. Now I've mixed in the second one. And then it goes to the filter. You can see here it's instantly showing you or displays you what you are doing and what how the sound is shaped. So this is really helpful. This is the filter. You have a filter section. So how much the filter applies. Then. Now you see the filter. You can make the filter. Right. And then you go to the amp section. You have an animal up here. So, no magic, and we have instantly a Blade Runner like sound or. So instantly you have a sound, so then you can save this. Okay. And when you say, okay, this is maybe a little bit boring, so you can modulate these sounds by an LFO, so-called low frequency oscillator. So instantly you have a pad, a sound, and it's with this synthesis, everything is like this. You can play around, experiment, and you have a very funny time with it. And so normally the LFO is limited, so you cannot do too much things, and this is maybe one of the cons. So it's on one hand, it's limited. But then you can see here this section, it has also this sequencer section. It's a step sequencer, so for example, I can record now here. So I recorded a sequence. This is one point of this sequencer. Now what is really interesting for the more modulation, modulating the sound. So you can also record motions of these knobs, for example. So now I recorded this motion. So you hear? And you can do this with every knob here, even when you change the waveforms. So you can record everything. And then it has also a built-in delay, and you can play around with this delay as well. You can record this movement as well, and then you have this fluttery tape effects. Instantly some lo-fi-ish sounds. You can do pads, you can do strong sounds, hard leads. For the leads, one hint. Normally, or if you look or buy something like this, or look a review, please look the review from the beginning to the end or read the manual, because you will miss something. On this I missed one point. I was missing a hard, harsh sound on it. Because sometimes it sounded for me a little bit too soft. And then you have different voice modes here. And one of the most important, I think, for hard sounds is the mono one here. I will go to it. So this is one oscillator. Then you turn up the second oscillator. And I said, okay, this is a little bit weak. And when you go to mono mode, it layers all the four voices of it. And then you get a so-called sub-oscillator. And you instantly have a fat sound, so you can do really fat, moreover like bass lines or something like this, record it, tweak around with it. So this is one of the secrets also to make it really fat. So I would say around second hand, around $400, or even if you buy it from new for $600, this is a great tool, great synthesizer. At the beginning I was really not happy with it, and I'm astonished now why I didn't like it. And for learning synthesis, subtractive synthesis, when you go into it, this is your thing for today. And compared to other synthesizers, you have warranty guarantee and everything. So it's something new. It has modern features. It has sync options, so you can hook up a Volca beat or something. What I would do when I would start these days, I would buy this cheap analog drum machine and the Strymon Big Sky synthesizer reverb for this synthesizer to make ambient music as a combination. For starting, only limitations, big limitations for me, the modulation a little bit and the four voices. You will notice that, because it has something also like called voice steam. When you change over the fourth note, so it takes from another one. But for the rest, it's a great synth. And now I give a big thumbs up to Cork. They did a great job with the synthesizer. And yeah. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, listen my music, give some likes, and I think I will make further videos of this and other gear of me. And thank you for watching, and have a nice day.